Okay, we've got a lot of questions about actually the mental aspects of doing true fire realistic flames in this exercise, which is two exercises in one. A and B is going to help you with that. Moving from doing the hot rod style flames where the sides are symmetrical, essentially mirrors of each other, to the true fire realistic flames. So what we're going to do is start off with a hot rod flame, and then we're going to draw a dissimilar one. Hot rod stylized flame, symmetrical flame, whatever you want to call it, and we're going to put the two together. Now again, look at photo reference shots. They're free all over the web on Google Images, Yahoo Images, on my website, chuckbauman.com. Whole galleries of flame photos that are going to help you do this a lot. So you want to print those off, save them, print them, keep looking at them. So here's your second hot rod flame lick, stylized flame lick. Hot rod or stylized flames look like they're supposed to look like flames, but they don't look like flames. So we want to go to that, to something that looks like flames. The hot rod style flames are really cool. They are sort of analogous to drawing stick figures instead of actual portraits of people. They look like they're supposed to look like flames, but clearly aren't. Flames clearly don't really look like flames. And what we're trying to do true fire, is go ahead and do a different kind of flame, and that's one that's photorealistic. And this is a very simple, we're going to take a step in your brain from doing symmetrical flames where the left and right sides match to doing true fire flames. We'll bisect these two flames and cut the center apart there as well. We're going to set the middle ones side for now and work with these outer ones. I'll bring in a sheet of paper to make this a little bit easier to see. And ta-da! There's a true fire flame. It's that simple. Your brain will start doing this. If you do this exercise enough times, your brain will do this on your own. And then you can just draw. And you move the angle around, change the angle relative from one side to the other, and get completely different flame look. You can draw in your wispy lines, your inner legs, whatever you want to call them, and help you work on that aspect of doing the flames. Again, you do this with pencil, not a marker. I'm using a marker just so you can see it on the video here. And that would be your inner legs, wispy lines. You could move one side up, down, and again, completely come up with completely different flame licks doing just that. And after a while, your brain will just start forming these. Doing this exercise and also looking at those photos, realistic actual photos of actual flames, here we'll match up the two here, your photo reference shots that are all over, come up with a tip. You can either do a saddle or a tip point or both, where you've got a hollow cord top there that's kind of a volcano top, I'd call that. This would be a line, if you do a stark line like that, that you'd highlight in shadow with the airbrush, where the flame lick looks like it's twisting around, and it gives it more 3D effect rather than just going left to right. Toss in your wispy lines. Do a million different things with these. If you do this for 15 or 20 minutes, you'll probably not have a problem anymore. And another thing to do is do connect the curves, where you just put down a bunch of random curves. Here I'm using a marker, you'd use a pencil. And if you want to do this with airbrushing, you just do it with the airbrush using the templates to throw a bunch of random curves down, going different directions, different radiuses, different size curves. And then you start seeing how to connect them in your mind and come up with, again, asymmetrical, realistic looking flames. A million different ways you can do that. And again, I'm going to make sure I really emphasize this here. I'll do a saddle at the top here. You got to really emphasize looking at the photo reference shots, and those are free everywhere. Some people will try to sell you a CD of photo reference shots, and they're all available. There's a million shots of flames and everything else you need a photo reference shot of, by the way, on the web, free of charge. I've got an entire gallery for free on my website at chuckbauman.com. You can go to Google main page and click on the top on images and do a search. Instead of on a web search, you're doing an image search for flames or fire and so forth. look at those photo reference shots, and also look up some video of flames too, or go photograph or film your own campfire, and then work on these exercises.